for you make me. Don't let them break me. Come and save me, Lord, from accidental discharge.
Lord, you make me out of nothing and make me into something. Save me from my enemies that haunt me and defend me, Lord, from accidental discharge. Lord, you make me out of nothing and make me into something. Save me from my enemy that haunts me and defend me, Lord, from accidental discharge.
Lord, you make me, don't let them break me. Come and save me, Lord, from accidental discharge.
Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of detention, I fear no evil, cause thou art with me, O Lord, from accidental discharge. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of detention, I fear no evil, cause thou art with me, O Lord, from accidental discharge.
See, one madman went on the trouble for this area.
A madman that kidnapped somebody's baby ran into your compound.
Into this compound.
And whether he likes it or not, that madman must die.
Confirm he must
die. Pastor! Say what you did ask me.
Pastor! Pastor, say you don't see. Pastor, Pastor, say you don't see.
I go, Pastor!
Wait.
Pastor, what did happen?
Pastor, go cooperate.
Say, you are Pastor.
Wait.
We have not come here to attack you. We know you to be a very genuine gentleman of God. So, please, Pastor, go inside and produce the madman. Simple.
Pastor, go inside, go bring the way, maybe chop out. Everyone suck blood. You know, now, Pastor.
Sure. Hey, man, ma. If you know I'm gonna stab you, die. But I mean, you go inside, go bring the mouse.
Pastor,
I go,
Peshi, leave on. This man a pastor now.
All right. All you want me to do is to go inside there and bring the madman for you, right?
Exactly, Pastor, confirm.
All right.
Pastor, go inside, go.
The pastor go cooperate.
You guys, I think I have a better idea.
Pastor, forget the idea.
I don't trust you, these boys, I will let you bad. Pastor.
Okay. You know what?
You have an idea. We are listening.
You know what?
What?
I want us to give this madman a befitting publicity. 7 days. 7 days. I want us to give him a befitting publicity for 7 days.
7 days, say wait. Pastor, say wait.
People of this will be aware that it's not good for us to have this kind of people amidst us. Please, let us give it time, please. 7 days is enough.
Pastor! If not for your antecedents in this community, if not for your gesture in this environment, this is not the first time this madman, this stupid idiot will be committing this kind of atrocity in this area.
Pastor.
How can a kidnapper be feigning as a madman? Come on, dumb old boy. Come as you were a dumb old boy. Pastor, come put you move.
But do you know what? You know something?
I want the government to realize that it is not good to have madmen in amidst the gentle people around us. It is just like keeping the lion amidst the gentle wolves. So we are going to make the government to be aware of that. So we have to make the public announcement and the public execution before we take any law into our hands.
Pastor, leave grammar for grammar people. Leave, we don't yet. Pastor, 7 days, I trust you.
7 days.
See, if not, they say I don't know you for this area as a gentleman of God. If I release these boys for you,
I appreciate you for recognizing me that I am a good man in this community.
Pastor, because of you,
But you know something? Let us tell those in government how terrible it is
to live with this kind of madmen, or I mean madmen in the community, Pastor. It is just like keeping the wild animal amidst the gentle sheep. So let us tell him, let us make announcement. So by the time we're going to execute him, everybody will be aware about it. What about that?
Pastor.
Just 7 days.
Pastor.
Yeah.
See, not to say I gentle. Eh? Don't take the gentility of a lion as madness.
The pastor thinks it's not
fair
for
you. Wait. Pastor, 7 days.
7 days.
7 days.
Yes, 7 days.
And after 7 days, we came here. 1, 2, 3. Today, yes, just 3 in number.
Abeg, leave grammar for grammar people. Leave, we don't hear. Pastor, 7 days, I trust you.
7 days.
See, if not be say I don't know you for this area as a gentleman of God. If I release these boys for you,
I go chop your flesh.
I go choke you.
God.
On a leave 7 days.
7 days.
7 days.
7 days.
Young man, take a look at the seat over there. I believe you can see it.
Yes, I can.
This is the junction where people attain their highest height in life. And you supposed to have been in this place long time ago. Therefore, go and sit there.
I should go and sit there.
My friend, it has been a long time. What is it? Eh? The world is waiting for your glory. It is time for you to shine. Kindly come up. Yes, I know you can make it.
Hello, friend. Where have you been since all this? The world is looking unto you for your glory.
Your glory is at your hand. Your position is vacant. You can still make it.
Where do you think you are going?
That sea does not belong to you.
God, at this point in time, I'm passing through difficulties. This man is here sleeping. Oh God.
Yeah.
Honey, what is it, my dear? Talk to me. What happened? Why are you screaming?
Dreadful dream.
Dreadful dream again? May the Lord help us, not just in the dead of the night, but dreadful dream in the day. Ah, God. Anyway, you have a letter.
Letter?
Yes.
From who?
It's for you.
And what is the content of the letter?
Collect it and go through it. Then you will know the content.
What? Honey, what is your offense? What have you done to them?
It happens that...
Lord, you made me. Don't let them break me. Come and save me, Lord. Lord, you made me. Don't let them break me. Come and save me, Lord, from my sin and this charge.
Lord, you make me out of nothing and make me into something. Save me from my enemy that haunts me and defend me, Lord, from accidental discharge. Lord, you make me out of nothing and make me into something. Save me from my enemy that haunts me and defend me, Lord, from accidental discharge.
Lord, you make me. Don't let them break me. Come and save me, Lord, from accidental discharge.
Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of the tension, I fear no evil, cause thou art with me, O Lord, from accidental discharge. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of the tension, I fear no evil, cause thou art with me, O Lord, from accidental discharge.
Lord, you make me. Don't let them break me. Come and save me, Lord, from accidental discharge.
Though there be plenty that are waiting for my death and destruction, surely they will bow before me, cause you are my King, O Lord, from accidental discharge. Though there be plenty that are waiting for my death and destruction, surely they will be bow before me, cause you are my King, O Lord, from accidental discharge.
Lord, you make me.
Hello, come in.
Good day, sir.
Mrs. Lawrence, how are you?
Fine, sir. Sir, you asked me to come for a business discussion with others.
Actually, I wanted us to have our first meeting, private meeting, before we join others for the general meeting.
All right, sir. But what are we discussing?
You look so uncomfortable and curious. Why don't you sit down? You're same with me. Sit down. Bridget.
Sir, what are we discussing?
Bridget. Actually, I want us to start going out. I want us to have a relationship, you know. I love you.
What did you just say?
I love you. I will take care of you. Okay. How does being the admin manager, or how does being the branch manager, or the admin controller sound to you?
It sounds good. I like that. But not for this satanic move of yours.
Listen, all I need from you is to accept and let us be together. You will see how I will take care of you. Listen, if you allow me, I will turn your life around. Your life will not remain the same again. Bridget, come close. Come close. Why are you talking like this?
Don't try that to part with me. What do you think you are doing?
What are you talking about? Let me take care of you. I love you. I will take you all over the world. I will buy you cars, houses, clothes. All you need is to say yes to me.
I don't need any of those things you mentioned. So, your intention is to rape me, right?
How can I rape you? How can I rape you? I can't rape you. I can't rape you. All I need is, you know, I just want to take care of you, that's all. But is it a crime to be in love?
Love? Love a married woman?
Live married. Live married. I'm married too. Look, I'm married. But these things happen. Okay? It happens. What? Listen. This is a game everybody plays. It's called chop and clean mouth. All you need to do is just agree with me.
What if my husband gets to know about this?
Are you a tata? Tatas are boys and babies who still suck breast. You just need to arrange, know how to play your game, and that's it. I'm telling you, if you just understand what I'm saying, you won't have anything to worry about. You have nothing, absolutely nothing to worry about.
What of my faith in Christ? Mr. Davido, or what do you call yourself? I don't want to know. Others may, but I cannot. You as a man, if you catch your wife with another man, how will you feel? Tell me, how will you feel?
Is that your decision?
Yes, that's my decision.
That's your final answer?
That is my final answer.
Okay, you can go.
Good day, sir.
Bridget. Bridget. Bridget.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
What is this for, sir? What? Sack letter? But, sir, I'm dedicated to my work, committed to my work, and always punctual at my place of work. What have I done to deserve this?
Mrs. Lawrence, that is the result of the test you wrote yesterday.
Oh my God!
Good day.
Excuse me, sir. Esther.
You know I'm a born-again Christian. I've never for once compromised my faith. Why are all this happening to me? Why? Why are they happening to me? God, why?
Why?
Why? Why?
My dear. Calm down. All shall be well. You know what? Challenges beget promotion.
It's getting too much. It's too much.
And predicaments bring people closer to God. Though some people run away from God in times of difficulties. But in our own case, I want us to be more closer to God. I believe in the power of prayer. Let's keep praying. I know prayer changes things.
They are awake. Awake,
awake. I would have told you. So go back to the village. That your place is not in the city.
You are a liar. A blatant liar you are. I will not go back to my village empty-handed.
don't care to know what you are holding. I don't want to know.
This is a kind of affliction. I will beat all your benefactors until they visit the grave this year.
That is not my portion. In Jesus' name, I rebuke you. In Jesus' name. The Bible says, "If thou break an edge, serpents will bite." For breaking the edge of my life, serpents will bite you today. In the name of Jesus. The Bible says, "He that dig a pit shall fall into it." Every pit of poverty, disappointment, death, pain, and affliction, dug for me. You will sum my shot into it in Jesus' name.
Keep shut. For calling that name on me, you will pay.
What is it?
I had a terrible dream. My dear. No.
What is that on your body?
It's a lie.
What's all this?
It's a lie. So, the mark is showing all over my body for real.
And it comes to reality.
Yes. The marks. All over my body.
This needs to be done. My dear. This is terrible.
Serious.
Hello, I'm fine. Oh, how are you, Daniel? My father. Okay, I'll do that. Thank you.
Bread and 50 naira pepper. Make it snappy. I'll go.
Datu!
So this is where you are. I've searched everywhere looking for you. What are you doing here?
Mommy Datu, don't be offended.
Yes, Angit. Witch in the church. You proved to be a fervent Christian, but you lack testimony. Look at you. Well, I can't blame you. Who knows? Maybe you have aborted all your children or you have submitted them to the witch before you give yourself to the church.
Mommy Dotun. Why all this now?
Dotun, give her money and let's
please
go, Joe.
You mean he should give me my money?
Yes. Give her money and money. Let's go.
That every month, tears refuses to cease from your eyes.
Yeah. Why will tears stop flowing from my eyes when the Lord refused to answer my prayers? And besides, do you remember what your mother said the other time she came on a visit?
afternoon, dear. Good afternoon. How are you?
Fine.
Please, help me to call Bolaji from my side.
Okay. He's coming.
Thank you, my dear.
Mommy, you are welcome, but why can't you come inside?
Me? To go inside this house? God forbid.
Hey, Mama.
Unless I'm a bastard. Olaji, if I'm your biological mother, by the end of this year, if that May banana tree refuses to get pregnant in this house, I'll bring another woman for you.
Oh, Mama, things will soon be alright, please. Things will soon be alright, please, Mama.
Mama, you're welcome. Good afternoon, Ma. You're welcome, Ma. Don't be offended. I overheard all your discussions. Please, in due time, the Lord will give me my own child. Please, Mama, don't be offended.
Please send me that.
Mama, are you going?
Mama, please.
Mama, please, come back. Oh.
Don't worry.
But dear.
Don't worry.
Why is Mama behaving this way? Why did she refuse to understand?
Don't worry.
But God. Believe you're on the train. Your mother said by the end of this year, she's going to bring another woman to you that will bear you a child, and it remains just 2 months to go. 2 months to go. Just 2 months to go.
God is in control. Stop disturbing yourself. The Bible says, He maketh all things beautiful at His own time.
At His own time. At His own time.
This is your elder brother's number, since he wants to speak with you.
No, pick the call.
Daddy, I lack the best adjective to use in appreciating you for rescuing our father.
Thank you, sir.
If not for you, sir, what will have happened to our father?
To God be the glory.
I was busy thinking about my life. And my wife just told me about the dream she had. When a friend calls and tells me about the predicament of my father. Sir, let me put my father's case aside. My life is facing a serious hell, and all my nights were full of nightmares. I mustn't close my eyes. The little source of income we have is from my wife's business. Now she has been sacked.
Daddy, the case of my brother is a peanut. In fact, it is a kindergarten type compared to the hot hell I'm passing through in my marriage. Over the issue of childlessness, it was as if the whole world engages in fierce battle with me. Daddy, this is one of the mysteries I do see. Is full of surprises. Life is a citadel of mysteries. Can you imagine an ordinary animal, and for that matter, at a go, had 7 to 8 chicks behind her, and I, created in the image of God, prayed all day long without any. But the Bible says in the book of Psalm 2, verse 8, ask of me, and I shall give you.
Grace, I can read your mind. All you are thinking within your heart boils out to childbearing. At least, here comes your child.
My child?
Yeah.
Praise the Lord! Thank you, Jesus. Victory at last. Lord, you are wonderful. Lord, you are faithful. My baby. You mean my baby? Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Jesus! And what is this? No, 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 I reject it! What is this? No, I reject you. This is not my... This is not my... No, this is not my baby. I don't want... Why are you coming? Why are you coming to me? I don't want this one. I want baby, not this one. No.
Truly you see chicks behind N. But people will never see child in your hand.
Jesus!
Listen to me. My name is Shadow.
Shadow?
Yes. And Shadow is invisible object that can never turn to reality.
Yeah! I reject it! No!
Let me tell you, as long as you touch these statues, your hand can never carry baby in life.
No! No! I don't want you. Don't come to me again. No, no, I reject it. What again? Please go away from my life.
Daddy, what is my crime? What is my crime? My husband and I were sound children of God. Daddy, now you don't understand.
Don't worry. The Lord is in control. All you've got to do is to come back to see Him in 2 days' time. By the special grace of God, the Lord is going to reveal to us everything that is bothering you. So, relax. My brother, calm down. The Lord is in control. Let us pray.
Beloveds,
these are the mysteries that God revealed to me about your father after my prayer for him.
My son,
hold on, you are in the presence of the Lord. God will take control. God will take control. Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus.
My son.
Yemi! Yemi!
My son! Yeah!
Oma, hold on. Calm down.
Yes,
you are in the house of the Lord. Jesus has never failed.
Yes.
And of a truth, yes, he will never fail.
Yes.
Something is wrong somewhere. Okay, you know what? You may go now. You may go out.
Give me just 3 days. Then come back after 3 days. By that time, I will have spoken to God. You understand me? You can go. Don't cry again. Wipe your tears. Just go. Don't worry. Go, 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 go. My God, what is going on? Have I made any mistake? We never had any record of an elderly person died in this church for many years. Talk less of a child, an innocent child. Have I made a mistake of not consulting God before I accepted that child? Or what? Okay. Mommy. Yes. I have to be in the church for the next 3 days. No problems. I need to talk to God. I have some scores to settle. No, 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 don't worry, don't worry, don't worry, don't worry. Don't worry, don't worry. God, in the mighty name of Jesus, every power, every principality that is sending you into the grave is cancelled. Fire, come down from the throne of God. Every evil people of your father's house, every evil spirit of your mother's house, I join you together. I call fire to come down from the throne of God and devour you. Fire! Fire! Come down from the throne of God.
Are you blind? Don't you see our mark on the boy's body? If you don't see the mark, don't you know that you've shared and eaten his flesh? Don't try to rescue that boy. Otherwise.
Otherwise, what? Is that a threat?
Don't dare me, my friend. If you do, you are endangering your life. I don't know why. You deliverance ministers will not ask before you lay your hands on victims.
Do I need to do any findings before delivering an oppressed in the name of the Lord? Do I? That is my purpose in the world.
I know you are a mad dog. And a mad dog that will perish will never listen to the voice of an hunter. If you are not a bastard, I know you are a bastard. Dear me. Dear me. And you'll be roasted by fire.
No. I will. I stand on the rock. Jesus Christ. I will save his soul from destruction. I will not stop.
In the name of Jesus, I decree that every power, every principality that is in against the life of this boy is cancer. Is cancer in the name of Jesus. Every evil power. Jesus.
Let me have his hand. I've been seeing this long ago. What is the offense of the mother of that boy? Does that mean anything to you? Come on, eat your meat. We are enjoying it, Adam. Come on.
Son of woman! This is the time for the children of life. To save the soul of God from the hands of the enemy eating all our flesh.
Lift up your eyes, O ye gates, and be lifted, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory will come in.
Who is that King of glory?
Jehovah God Almighty, strong and mighty in battle. The scripture says, wherefore God also highly exalted him, giving him a name that is above every other name, that the name of Jesus Christ, every knee shall bow, Jesus himself on earth,
under the earth beneath it. I command rain of fire because I stand upon Jesus Christ the rock. I command rain of fire to come upon you right now in the name of Jesus. Rain of fire to come upon you right now in the name of Jesus. Rain of fire!
Hold on! What do you want us to do for you?
Give me the flesh of Yemi. The son of Mundo that you have eaten. The flesh of Yemi is what I want from you. Yes! Vomit it. This is victory.
I pray in the name of Jesus, after this victory, you this boy, you come to life in the name of Jesus. Life will come back into you in the name of Jesus. I decree that your life will come back in the name of Jesus. Yemi.
The fake pastor you're talking about?
Yes, he's the one.
Pastor.
You're welcome.
You are under arrest.
Under arrest?
Yes.
Please let me pick my Bible.
Pick your Bible? Come on, let's go. You still want to pick your Bible?
Please, as a pastor, don't let me go without my sword. That's my power. Let me pick my Bible.
Well, you can go. Pastor. Don't try to perform any nonsense there, because whatever you say here is what we are going to use against you in the court of law.
Okay.
But, madam, what's going on here?
I'm sorry, my son is alive.
Your son is alive?
Yes, my son is alive.
What? There's no problem. There's no problem.
Sorry, please forgive me. Forgive me. This is the only son I have. That's why I lived that way. I'm sorry.
I know.
Pastor, forgive me. Oh, you said something was wrong that day.
Yes, truly I said that something must have been wrong. This is what the Lord revealed.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We bless the name of the Lord for the success of the naming of our baby. And I pray for you that in the day of your joy, you will never be alone in Jesus'
Amen.
Name.
Amen.
So we thank you. We appreciate you for coming for the naming today. And after this, just please wait a little bit. We have a gift that we want to give every one of you. And as you are eating that food, it shall be a healing meal for you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
God bless you as we witness this glorious day. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hey, mommy, I share my own. I share dupe. Mommy, I share. I could joke, mama. I share dupe.
Yes, ma'am.
Hey, Big bros, Alpha. Eze o, you are welcome. Eya, Timi, Aburo. Eze o, Akujoko. Eze go o, Adupa o. Eze mo dupa ko aduro ti o. Olorun ni seyin na lenikan, eze o.
You are well done. I just want to inquire if I've offended you.
Offended me? You've not offended me in any form. But why did you ask?
Yes. The reason is that when you served me, I saw a head of fish on my food. While others were given turkey, cow meat, chicken. To worsen the situation, the children and the youths were given better food than I. With that, I concluded maybe I've offended you.
Ewo, my Jesus. So you excuse me out of the church because of food? Food? Oh. Charity, they say, begin at home. I don't know why some people are gluten. If you desire enough meat, aren't you know the way to Abatia to go and get yourself enough meat to eat? Anyway, I was not the one that put the food in the plates. I don't know anything about fish, cats, or ram. Mine is just to serve people. Excuse me.
Very good. The evil gun of the Council of Elders. Why is it so hot and urgent like that? I just have to take it at all costs.
But who do you have clash?
It was a woman that disgraced me.
It is Tupe, the daughter of Ajibike, that failed to give you meat in the naming ceremony of Adetutu.
Ah, Mama. How are you so accurate in your prediction?
Take a look at this.
Inasmuch you are my follower,
my eyes follows you around like a protection. This is what we use to monitor and guide all. Now, tell me, what do you want me to do for you?
Haven't seen that the boy is the only child of Dupe. I would like to terminate his life with the evil god of the elders.
Is that what you want?
Yes.
Be warned. You have to return it tonight because somebody is coming tomorrow to take it for another assignment.
Yes.
is time to cause serious and terrible tears to flow out of Dupe's eyes. Dupe, for refusing to give me meat, I will eat the meat of your child. Olayemi. Olayemi oh! Olayemi oh! Olayemi oh! The son of Ajike, is your mother that offended me?
You see? You see what your mouth has caused you? You see what your tongue have put into your life? Let me tell you something. When you are in the church of God, not all the people that are there are godly people. The woman or man that is sitting by your left or right might mortgage your destiny if you are not careful. Be very careful. You don't know the type of spirit that is in that person. It can be a little boy or a little girl or an elderly person. It doesn't matter. So wash your tongue. Wash your tongue. It's very important.
In order to save our time, Madam Razorblade's mouth. Well, you don't have your own time now. Pastor, you still need to follow us to our station. Because you know, I'm not here on my own.
What? The boy is alive.
I know he's alive. I know. You just follow us to station. We just need to give us little statements there. Then you come back to your church.
Statement? Okay. Now let me pick my Bible with me.
Send me parking by the end of this month. What will I tell him? He has come his trouble. What will I tell him?
Oh God.
Hello, sir. Good afternoon, sir. Yes. But I'm not around now, sir. I'm in Apure. I will come back by the end of the month. Yes, sir. When I come back, I will let you know. Okay, sir. Hey, it's very unusual. I've lied to this man. Very, very unusual.
Hey, why did I lie to him? Why? Why did I? Oh, Abby, I should call him back and tell him that I'm around. After all, he can't kill me. To lead you to me. Nothing. He can't kill me.
Yes! Let me start with that. I have looked for a way of catching him, but all road was blocked. Until today, when he told a lie. Where is the evil padlock? Yes, I will lock up his prayer life with this satanic padlock. You witches of the four corners of the hells, take this into your coven.
Yeah, daddy.
I'm getting involved with my first child.
Yes! I've succeeded
instead implanting a lifetime evil seed into the future of your children. Though the bullets were not targeted on them, but it was accidentally discharged on them.
Ah, wonderful. So it's a dream. I said it. It must be a dream. It must be a dream.
Daddy, what happened?
I had a dream.
A dream?
Yes. Come and see. Come and see. A snake in the bedroom.
A snake?
Snake, no. Can't you see? Can't you see?
I can't see anything.
See.
Daddy.
Look at the big line. A big line. Bring the compass. Bring the gun.
I can't see anything, Daddy.
Accidental discharge? Yes, accidental discharge. Those bullets were not meant for you. They were meant for your father.
Jesus.
But accidentally, it relocated and came back to you. This is how so many children of God, they encounter difficult situations and circumstances through the crime committed by their father. A lot of children of God today, they are paying for the crime committed by their father, unknowingly suffering for nothing's sake.
What can we do?
To every problem, there is a solution. A true prophet will give you a prophecy of a certain problem and solution will be attached to it. So, all you have to do is to get 3 bottles of anointing oil.
3 bottles of anointing oil? Is it the 3 for both of us or?
You 3 bottles, our own is 3 bottles.
Making 6.
And you spend 3 days in fasting and prayer in the church. After that, I will conduct deliverance for you. I am telling you, the bullet that is directly affecting your life and destiny, shot by the power of darkness, will vacate your life by fire in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Should I do it?
Yes, Maria was with us. Yes.
No time, maybe we just enter the place.
I don't tell and say today if we show.
There's no problem.
Why are not the gate?
I better come out too.
No, come on. Open the gate, then come out now.
We're waiting now.
Then swear for you, they crazy.
We're waiting now.
Pastor. Do you remember we came? I led a gang of towns here 7 days ago. And you actually promised us to come back in 7 days. Only the name of doing publicity for the execution of the madman. Now we have come. Look at him. His name is Scorpion. His name is Lion. And you already know Chingon. It won't take them just one single minute to dismantle this place. So, Pastor, cooperate. Just go in and bring out the madman. We are ready to execute jungle justice here. Confirm, simple.
You know what?
Hey, Pastor! Me, I know the shout, I know the joke at all. You see, I'm about to. I've really break your head. Go inside the door.
Cooperate! You don't tell me.
No time to check my time.
You know.
This is the madman you're talking about. This is the madman you want to see.
Yeah. Scorpio. Hey, nice job.
Brothers.
Hey, press, wait a minute now.
Hey, what's it be this one? This one, you go put on code. You gotta tell me, say you be mad, man.
You gotta turn my life around.
Hey, 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 Sam. Beg no talk again, Joe. No talk. Sam, me, I know the joke at all. I know they play.
Lion.
I know they play, no be your fault.
Lion, you know
that. Because you the fumble, the fumble. In the farm, you know, send a strong work me and they do. I know they do can't work. Sianna, listen, oh, listen. Anytime you want to call me on sure work. Egna, get out, Joe.
Lion.
Get out, Joe.
Bless you, what you do now, you fuck up. Now, two call you together that time. You tell me, say, me, call me this man today. You can't call you now. You can't come for back or collect money. No be your fault. You know, no be your fault.
Pressy. Now because you be my man, I make me
Scorpion, stay here. Trust me now.
This man don't resemble madman.
Do you know I can't deceive you? I don't feel deceive you now.
This man don't resemble madman.
Actually led others into this place. We chased this madman. Sorry, this once upon a time madman. Into this place. Look at that. Yes, now. That same dark mark beside the forehead is still there. Hey, Pastor, tell me something. What actually happened? What kind of miracle transformed the life of once upon a time madman into becoming a responsible person, well-dressed in suit, in well-polished shoe? Tell me something, Pastor.
This is what I'm saying. You see, this is nothing but miracle.
Yes.
This is the work of God.
Yes.
This is the work of God. Is a man that is insane. Is a man that the world has written off. But God turned his insanity to sanity.
Yes.
He recovered. And the Lord made him a new man.
Yes.
That is what the Lord can do.
Yes.
That's what the Lord, that's a miracle.
Yes. Yes.
That is it.
Miracle?
Yes.
Yes. Are you now saying? Because this man was actually insane. I mean, he was mentally ill. But are you, as you are seeing us, we are actually the ones they call social madmen. Are you saying the power or whosoever or whatsoever transformed this life of once upon a time madman can also do the same in our own lives, bringing us out of social insanity into being responsible men in the society?
Man of God.
Yes, sir.
Saul, that was called Paul in the Bible.
Yes.
What is his work?
He was a murderer.
A murderer.
A killer.
A murderer.
A destroyer.
Yes.
A tout.
An enemy of God.
Enemy of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes. But his life God was.
He changed entirely.
An entire change came upon him.
He became a new man.
And a new name came upon him.
Yes.
Yes. There is no level that one can go in insanity, social insanity, or physical insanity, whatever name you can call it, that the Lord cannot heal such a one. All you need do is to accept him as a Lord and Savior. Accept Jesus Christ.
So, Pastor, tell us, how do we accept Jesus? Just show us this Jesus that you've been talking about. Tell us something. Show us Jesus. Let's grab him. I'm ready to grab that Jesus. I've been a Pastor. So that our lives also can get transformed.
He gave his only begotten Son.
That whosoever believeth in him
will not perish,
but have everlasting life.
Everlasting life. That is the Son of God. And the Lord, the Bible says, that as he said, come unto me,
all ye that labor
and are heavy laden,
and I will give you rest.
My yoke is easy, and
my body is light.
Yes, my body is light. Yes. All you need to do is to go on your knees and confess Jesus. You will never accept Jesus into your pores, into your mouth, but into your heart.
Pastor, please, don't go that way. See, because if we allow to confess all our sins, I'm very sure the kind of atrocities we have committed in this world, in this life of ours, even Jesus Christ will change his mind from forgiving us. Please, do not let us confess our sins. Our sins are so, we've committed wicked atrocities.
There's no problem.
Let me pray with you. Father, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, I pray that you will heal, you will save this one is in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Write their name in the book of life.
Amen.
Lord, I pray that you forgive them with your mercy in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Cleanse them from their sins in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Write their name in the book of life.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus, we pray.
Amen.
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 You see, you know what?
Just like that.
There's going to be a joy that will flow into your life like a river of water.
Yes.
You see, my brothers, you know what? The Lord told us to give you three gifts.
The first is to take you up the street and give you a house. The second is to give you a job. And the third is to give you a car.
Pastor, I actually understand where Pastor is coming from. You see, Pastor, let me tell you something. See, when we decided earlier to accept Jesus Christ into our lives, we actually meant what we meant. See, it won't take us anything to live exactly the same way others left. But the same way we accepted immoral lives, we have actually transformed again and accept this new life you are offering us. So I perceive, Pastor, that you're actually using this issue of new car, new house, and employment to tie us down into getting us serious. Pastor, no, you don't need that.
No, no.
You see, my brother, what the Lord will not do,
he won't say it.
What the Lord will not do, he won't say it.
He won't say it.
So it is what the Lord is going to do.
Hey, today is what?
Today is Sunday.
Today is Sunday. On Wednesday. Wednesday. Please, try to come and see me on Wednesday. Come and see us on Wednesday.
We have Bible study on Wednesday.
Yes, we're going together. So on Wednesday, we're going to see.
Daddy.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The Lord has done it for us.
I can see that the Lord has done it.
Yes.
In fact, and I rejoice with you. So I can now see that you are no longer a victim of accidental discharge.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Lord is great. Hey, what about your husband?
Oh, that is not around.
He has traveled out. Okay, he has traveled out.
Yes.
Oh, thank God. Daddy, if you can see and you look vividly, the Lawrence of death and the grace of death, you see that there are changes in her life.
Yes.
God turns everything around. So, in the name of my family and my lovely wife and my younger sister,
yes,
we have a token, just a token, to give you, sir.
Just a token, sir.
It is a prophet offering. So let me see what is there.
Token,
no, don't tell me this is what it is.
Just token.
2 million. It's a token. 2 million.
Just yes, only.
Because you've done this, the doors of success, doors of great glory,
amen,
doors of abundance,
amen,
will be opened unto you,
amen,
in the mighty name of
Jesus.
Now, viewers, listen to me. Can you see now that these people are no longer victims of accidental discharge?
Yes.
Because they gave their life to Jesus Christ. If you don't want to be a victim of accidental discharge, all you've got to do is to accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. Right there, confess your sins and tell God you are sorry. God is merciful. He will abundantly pardon. He will forgive your iniquity. Ask Him. Ask for His mercy. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Now that I've done that, I want to pray together with you. I want to pray with you. Just close your eyes wherever you are. I join my faith with the faith of the families here.
Yes, Lord.
That by the grace of God, everyone here watching me,
yes,
or listening to me, or is victim of his accidental discharge, I pray that you are free in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray that the door of abundant success is open unto you in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
This is a production of Gospel Heroes Film International. By the grace of God, if you want to call us, just call us on the number going under the screen. So we'll be there to answer for you. And whatever may be your prayer point, call us. We're going to pray together with you. And God is going to bless you. Your story will change to glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Jesus is Lord.
Often, so many times, we fight an unknown battle, which is why so many cry. They never get their mantle. We seek and we don't find. But in the midst of history, if he means you not the same with me, the earth is our fruit. Our teeth are set on edge, oh God. I've soaked inside my tears, who brought on me this fear of accidental discharge.
Accidental discharge.